Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. As if it wasn't bad enough that we have to see overpaid spoiled sports stars kneeling for the national anthem, now we have to read about elected city council members doing the same thing. Monday night's Board of Selectmen meeting in this pastoral Connecticut River town featured a discussion on the closing of an elementary school, the awarding of a lawn care bid, and a deeply polarizing debate over the meaning of the First Amendment. As IJR reported, this whole mess was instigated at a board meeting earlier this month when Democratic selectwoman Melissa J. Schley decided it was okay for a public servant such as herself to kneel during the Pledge of Allegiance in protest of President Donald Trump's meeting with Russian leader Vladimir Putin, his stance on illegal aliens and other policies set forth by the president. But a veteran at the meeting wasn't going to take this standing still. He is 100% correct. If you want to disrespect the flag, that's okay, it's your right to do so, but do it on your own damn time. Public comments at a Board of Selectmen meeting in hashtag Haddam surrounding controversy of selectwoman Melissa Schley hashtag kneeling during the Pledge of Allegiance in protest of President Trump's policies. This veteran says he supports her right to free speech and to kneel. pic.twitter.com/jvozfxxs9way, Nia Ham, at Nia Ham TV, July 31, 2018. Here is more via the Hartford Courant. Monday night's Board of Selectmen meeting in this pastoral Connecticut River town featured a discussion on the closing of an elementary school, the awarding of a lawn care bid, and a deeply polarizing debate over the meaning of the First Amendment. The conflict was set off at a board meeting earlier this month when Democratic selectwoman Melissa J. Schley knelt during the Pledge of Allegiance to protest President Donald Trump's defense of Russian leader Vladimir Putin, his hard line on undocumented immigrants, and other policies put forth by the Republican president. Her stance, which echoes the public dissents of NFL players, drew harsh condemnation from critics, including several Republican gubernatorial candidates, and a spirited defense from supporters. Haddam selectwoman takes a knee during pledge to protest Trump, and an outcry ensues on Monday, the first board meeting after the controversy. Both sides came to the Haddam volunteer firehouse as the minutiae of small-town government gave way to an impassioned display reflecting the cultural and political fault lines of the Trump era. "This is political speech," Paul White, a 49-year-old local attorney, said over jeers from some in the audience. "Whether I agree or not, it doesn't matter. She has the right to convey a political message." But Calvin Bunnell, 71, came from Meriden to express his anger at Schley's silent protest. "You don't turn your back on the flag," he said. He wore a t-shirt emblazoned with a message: "If you don't like this flag, I'll help you pack your bags. I did not go to Vietnam to pick and choose who gets to be better Americans." Bob Wallin, Haddam. Bunnell served in Vietnam and, like many other veterans in the audience, views kneeling during the pledge as a sign of profound disrespect to those who served in the military. "I wholeheartedly respect your right to protest, to take a knee," said Pablo Arroyo, a 58-year-old town resident who served in the Marine Corps. "But if that's what you would like to do, do it on your own time. I am not here to disrespect you as you've done to my flag, my country." Arroyo recalled 18 Marines in his platoon who work A**D in A**D bombing in Beirut. Looking directly at Schley, he said, "What you did was urinate on all their graves." But not all of the veterans in the audience took the same view. Bob Wallin, a 71-year-old town resident and a combat veteran who served in Vietnam, delivered a poignant defense of Schley's constitutional right to peacefully protest. "I took an oath to defend the Constitution," Wallin said. "The Constitution starts with the First Amendment. She has that right. I'm not agreeing with her, and I think the reason she does it is stupid. I don't care." Wallin said he was exposed to Agent Orange and is suffering the effects of that exposure. As he offered up his brief comments, he grew too weak to stand and was given a chair and a bottle of water. "I did not go to Vietnam to pick and choose who gets to be better Americans," Wallin declared. Speaking to the politicians who have denounced Schley, he said, "Screw you. None of you earned that right. You people make me mad." Instead of expressing outrage at Schley on social media, Wallin implored the crowd to turn its anger toward helping veterans. "You want to be upset right on Facebook? Well, two veterans a day commit ************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************************ by Republican gubernatorial candidate Tim Herbst and Republican candidate for state treasurer Art Linners, held a rally on the town green. as Lee Greenwood's patriotic anthem, God Bless the USA, blasted from speakers to a crowd of around 100. Some in the crowd even sported Make America Great Again hats and Trump t-shirts. This garbage needs to stop. Schlage has every right to kneel for the flag, but not when taxpayers are paying her salary. She is 100% free to despise our flag, nation, and president all she wants. But she can do that on her own time and on her own dime. Schlage has officially said she will continue to kneel during the pledge until President Donald Trump is no longer in office. Note from the editor, the views and opinions expressed in this article are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the position of this website or of the owners, administrators of where this article is shared online. Claims are made in this piece are based on the author's own opinion and not stated as evidence of fact.